Alright, today I'm going to show you how to replace the charging port on the iPhone 6. If you want to watch the other repair videos, go ahead and click the links in the front of this one. Here's the iPhone 6. We're going to go ahead and turn it off. There are two pentalobe screws down at the bottom. If you need a pentalobe screwdriver, go ahead and check the video description right below this video. And I will link the parts and repair tools that you need there. Get your suction cup and lift up a little bit on the screen, and then you can get your pry tool and lift up on the edge of the frame on the screen. You want to lift up on the frame itself so you don't bend the screen and crack it. If you crack the screen, obviously you'd have a bigger problem than just your charging port. Lift up the screen, there's 5 screws on this metal bracket. Pull that guy off. You don't need to take off the screen for this repair, but it does make it a lot easier because the screen can't be folded past 90 degrees while it's still connected. Lift off these 4 ribbon cables, and then that releases the screen itself. Once again, replacement parts are in the video description if you need any of those. Now, to get at the charging port, you need to take off this little bracket, which is holding down the battery connection. So get rid of those 2 screws. Keep them organized. Place them right next to this little bracket so you don't lose them. Lift off the battery connector, and you don't need to take out the battery for this video, but I am going to just for the video's sake. It is a pain, so don't do it unless you absolutely need to. There's 4 screws on the loudspeaker. Disconnect that ribbon cable, and you have the wire cable here that I'm lifting up, and you can just kind of pull it out of the little bracket that's holding it down. And then the loudspeaker comes up and away from the phone itself. Once again, if you need any replacement parts, I'll have this link down below as well. So if your speaker's crackly or muffled or it's been water damaged or something like that, usually they're pretty cheap. So check those out. Here's the 2 little connectors for the loudspeaker, also on the charging port cable. Now we're going to take out the vibration motor. So there's 2 little screws on either side of that. Remove those, put them somewhere safe, and pull the motor out away from the phone. You can see the 2 little connectors right here, and those are what connect the 2 little contact points on the charging port. 4 screws on the charging port itself, another little bracket. Keep the screws close by the brackets. That's the best way to stay organized, I found. Then there's another screw and a little rubber piece down here by the microphone. Take out that screw, keep it next to the rubber piece, and set that where you're setting the rest of your screws in a very organized fashion. 2 more screws down by the charging port and 2 more on the top of the headphone jack. Remove those, keep them somewhere safe, and then you can start peeling the ribbon cable away from the phone. Be careful once you get down around this spot because the microphone and headphone jack are kind of inside the phone's frame. So lift those up and out, and then you can see the entire component right here. So these parts are normally pretty cheap. I will link those down in the video description as soon as they become available, so check those out. Putting it back in, you want to start with the headphone jack and microphone, putting those inside the frame, and then kind of bend and fold the ribbon cable to match the contour of the phone. That way it lines up where it needs to be. Get the metal bracket and those 4 screws in, then these 4 screws, and the 1 screw and metal piece that hold the microphone in as well. If you kept all your screws organized, this part will be easy. Get the vibration motor placed down on those 2 little contact points and screw it in. And you have the loudspeaker here. Sometimes you need to push the top in first. It's got little guiding brackets, and then the bottom will click in after that. Get those 4 screws in. Get the wire cable tucked down in that little metal groove there. And then pinch it down on its little connector right here. This one took me a couple tries just because it's so small. You'll hear it kind of a click in. And then you have the charging port connector right here. And then you just want to fold the battery back down and clip it in as well. Once again, you didn't have to take the battery out because it's a pain, but if you want to, you can. Get the little metal bracket screwed down as well. And then the screen, so many connections. Clip them all down, all 4 of them. They're kind of like little Legos, so position them right above the connector and then you'll hear it clip down in. Don't use too much force or you will bend them. And then your repair becomes more expensive. Get the metal bracket down and get those 5 screws also put into place. And then when you fold the screen down, the easiest way to do it is to guide the top into place first. It's got these little grooves that match up with the top of the frame. And then you can clip down along the sides of it and it'll snap in all the way down to the bottom next to the charging port. And then you get those 2 pentalobe screws back in and you are set. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and don't forget to subscribe. I put up videos fairly often and I hope to see you around. Thanks for watching.